This was an Earth Day that got more attention than many past, due in part to today's signing of the Global Climate Accord. But for all the celebrations surrounding that, there is still major concern about what's happening to the environment and the impact of development. That tension is playing out here in Alabama, with one of the United States' preeminent naturalists calling for the creation of a new protected area to cover a critical waterway. Jeffrey Brown has our report.
The Mobile-Tensaw Delta, where five rivers meet in southern Alabama to drain into the Gulf of Mexico. More than 200,000 acres of bog, marsh, swampland, and floodplain. It's one of the most biologically diverse places in North America, home to scores of species of flowers, birds, fish, turtles, and more.
And there are a tremendous variety of plants and animals in it.
It's also the childhood playground of Edward O. Wilson, where he searched out snakes and insects and worked as a 14-year-old counselor at nearby Camp Pushmataha.
It was wartime, and they didn't have any older, smarter kids to be nature counselor. So I just simply led the boys through the whole summer on expeditions, searching and capturing snakes. And we built up a fantastic collection of different species of snakes. And thus was born the naturalist, and thus was born the professor.
One of the world's best-known professors, a leading biologist and naturalist, and a two-time Pulitzer Prize-winning author. Now 86, Wilson's quest is to preserve the diversity of life on the Earth, including here in the Delta, where he and others have been lobbying for the creation of a new national park.
This is Golden Club. It's just one of the beautiful flowers, really a peculiar flower, isn't it?
Working with Wilson on the park effort and joining us in the Hurricane Bayou recently was writer and botanist Bill Finch.
It's a beautiful spring day here on the Gulf Coast.
Among his many roles, Finch hosts a Sunday morning call-in radio show in Mobile to talk nature, gardening, and the Delta.
We're going to talk about what is the future of this Delta? What is the future of Mobile Bay? Will it still be here in a few years for us?
Working in the Delta's favor, Finch says, is its sheer size and power. The water is simply too wild to do any major building here. Moreover, the state government has already protected tens of thousands of acres through its Forever Wild Land Trust, which uses taxes on oil drilling to purchase conservation lands.
We've done great work protecting this floodplain.
Where we are now.
Where we are now. The land was not expensive. It was not hard to purchase. But not everything lives in the floodplain, and even the turtles who live here require the dry land. What we've done a terrible job of is preserving the areas where people can develop, the areas that are drier than this.
Finch and Wilson took us to an area that has been protected, Splinter Hill Bog.
This is a leaf that is meant to look like a flower.
Home to carnivorous flowers like these pitcher plants, which use decoy flowers to trap their prey.
And the insects crawl in and can't get back out.
The bog also contains a longleaf pine forest, which Finch says is vital habitat for bears and other species. But this is a relatively small area, and Finch's real concern is development, which among other things replaces soil, plants, and natural water ecology with concrete and asphalt, sending mud and debris rushing into the Delta, clouding the water, and killing plant and animal life.
So what do you want to see? I mean, what kind of federal design?
You know, there's lots of ways. We've tried to do it alone as a state. We've tried to get some federal money, but there's lots of opportunities for getting more federal support for what we're doing and for getting federal attention for one of the most diverse areas in North America. And so, you know, the National Park Service provides some opportunities for that.
In 2013, the Mobile County Commission endorsed a plan to study the impact of a national park, but even that has drawn opposition.
If we give the federal government the power to protect the Delta, they are subject to abusing it.
Didn't grow up fishing or in boats, but when I became a commissioner, this was part of my district.
Merceria Ludgood is a Mobile County commissioner who favors the study, but knows that many of her constituents will be wary of going further.
You'll have the people on the one side who don't know anything about the Delta, its environmental implications for quality of life here. All they see is we need a job.
Yeah.
And so the conversation then gets fractured, and you have the people who want development, who want the jobs on one side, and the environmentalists on the other side. And what we've got to find is the way to marry that.
Opposition in this deeply conservative state also comes from suspicions of any federal intervention, especially one that could limit hunting and fishing, sports popular in the Delta.
The short answer for why not a national park here is it's not necessary.
Chris Elliott is a commissioner in Baldwin County, across from Mobile, and home to many new housing and commercial developments.
The people of South Alabama have traditionally opposed increased federal government oversight over our areas, and we just don't think it's necessary here in South Alabama. We're doing a fine job protecting this natural resource on our own.
He points to efforts like the state's Forever Wild Land Trust, as well as to local agencies like the Mobile Bay Estuaries Program, which in this large subdivision has been working to mitigate stormwater drainage problems caused by poor planning in the 1970s.
You can't just go in and restore a stream. You have to strengthen its ability to handle those larger quantities of stormwater runoff.
Roberta Swan is director of the estuaries effort.
This is not a natural stream restoration. This is an enhanced stream restoration. There are rocks in here that are not native. And the reason why it's not a true stream restoration is because we have to accommodate the impacts of humans on the environment.
Because that's inevitable.
It's inevitable. And if we were to turn the Delta into a national park, we would lose the ability to mitigate the human impacts on that ecosystem.
Agreement on the need to protect a precious natural resource, but vast differences on how to do it.
And that was part of the story of how many species you can get packed into
get a packed in there.
Bill Finch and Edward Wilson want to limit some development, but see a potential compromise with hunters and fishers in a national wildlife refuge designation that would still allow those sports to continue.
You know, there are a lot of options out there that we can explore that allow us to have it all in many ways, to do the things we're doing now, to have the kind of careful human use of the Delta that we've got now, but still preserve our biodiversity.
And for Ed Wilson, finding a way to protect the Delta of his youth is part of a much larger goal of setting aside half the earth for habitat, one which begins with a lesson in humility.
There are about 2 million species known worldwide of all kinds of organisms, and the total number of species is probably close to 10 million worldwide, meaning we've only discovered, much less studied, about 20% of all the species. So here is a world that is waiting for exploration, and that's just the beginning.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in the Mobile-Tensaw River Delta.